Whether it's 3ds Max or any other program, the speed and efficiency of the work relies heavily on shortcuts. In this video, we are going to see 20 shortcuts or 20 tips and tricks in 3ds Max that are unknown to most beginners or even advanced modelers. Let's get started. Number 20, the repeat last command. In some situations, we may want to do operations repeatedly. In this case, we have a polygon and we want to collapse each of these vertices. So we select these vertices and hit collapse. Select the next vertices. Now instead of finding the collapse button in the command panel every single time, we just press the semicolon key in the keyboard. What it does is, it repeats the last operation you did on the currently selected components. You can do this any number of times. If we want to connect these vertices, select and hit connect. And the next time, you can just press semicolon key on the keyboard. This saves a lot of time when you're modeling. Number 19, pivot mode. To change the pivot position of an object, you have to go into the hierarchy tab of the command panel and click Affect Pivot Only button. There is an easier way to do this. All you have to do is select the object, press Insert key on your keyboard, move the pivot point wherever you want to, and press Insert key to exit the pivot mode. Number 18, GIZMO. At certain times, you may run into situations where you feel the gizmo handles are standing in your way, especially when you tend to move your bezier handles in spline modeling. To turn off your gizmo, go to Customize, Preferences, and under Gizmo tab, turn off gizmo. But you don't have to do this all the time when there is a shortcut for it. All you have to do is press Ctrl, Shift and X to toggle gizmo on and off. Number 17, Expert Mode. When you're working in a small monitor, you may feel that the command panel and all the toolbars are taking up too much space and you do not have enough space for the viewports. To clean up the mess, press Ctrl and X. This is called the Expert Mode. To turn off Expert Mode, press Ctrl X again. Number 16, Undo Viewport Operations. Usually, we press Ctrl Z and Ctrl Y to undo and redo tasks respectively. But what if we want to undo the camera movements in the perspective viewport? For example, in this perspective viewport, I am rotating the camera. And I find this camera movement is undesirable. I want to go back to my previous state. To do so, I press Shift and Z. This undoes the camera movement. And Shift and Y redoes it. Number 15, Extrude. In editable poly mode, you can use the shortcut Shift and E to extrude faces, edges, and even vertices. Number 14, number 13, and number 12 or shortcuts for bevel, chamfer, and connect respectively. In editable poly mode, you can use Ctrl Shift and B to bevel faces. Ctrl Shift and C to chamfer vertices or edges. CTRL, SHIFT and E to connect vertices or edges. These shortcuts are bound to make your work easy. Number 11. Target Weld Mode. The shortcut for entering Target Weld Mode is CTRL, SHIFT and W. Number 10. Grow or Shrink Your Selection. When you press CTRL and Page Up, it makes your selection grow. And CTRL and Page Down makes it shrink. Number 9. Open Scene Explorer. CTRL, ALT and O opens up the Scene Explorer. However, this does not apply to a fresh new scene because this shortcut is meant for opening the last used Scene Explorer. And make sure you use the left side of the keyboard for CTRL and ALT buttons. If you use the right side of the keyboard for this shortcut, it opens up a new scene. The shortcuts number 8, number 7, number 6 and number 5 are for hiding or unhiding objects in 3ds Max. The shortcut SHIFT and C hides all cameras in your scene. To unhide, use the same shortcut again. SHIFT and L for hiding or unhiding the lights. SHIFT and G for hiding or unhiding geometry. SHIFT and S for hiding or unhiding shapes. Also understand, these shortcuts have nothing to do with the visibility of the objects. Number 4. Select by name. Sometimes we may want to select objects by name. The shortcut for this is H key on the keyboard. Number 3. Constrain to edges. To constrain the movement of vertices along the edges, you have to go up to the rapid ribbon and under the modeling tab, press constrain to edge button. The equivalent shortcut for this is SHIFT and X. Number 2. The Cut Tool. The shortcut for Cut Tool is ALT and C. To exit out of the Cut Tool, right-click twice. Number 1. Ring or Loop Selection. If we want to select a loop of edges, double-click on an edge. If we want to select a ring of edges, select one edge and shift-click on any one of the other edges in the ring. The same applies for vertices and faces. And there are a few other shortcuts that are mentionable. CTRL, ALT and V for hiding or unhiding view cube, SHIFT and F for save frames, ALT and X for X-ray mode, ALT and Q for isolate, G for turning grid on or off, F10 render setup, F9 render last frame, SHIFT and CTRL and Q for quick slice mode, CTRL and I select invert, CTRL and Q select similar. Are these shortcuts new to you, or do you use them regularly? Share your thoughts in comments below. Like or dislike the video accordingly. And do not forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.